were to send her clothes?
I told you, sir. She took them all with her.
Pickering! Pickering!
What's what?
Ah, here's the confounded thing. Eliza is bolted.
Bolted?
Yes, bolted. And Mrs. Pierce lets her go without telling me a word about it.
Well, I'm dashed.
I don't know what to do. I had tea this morning instead of coffee. I can't find anything. I don't know what appointments I've got.
Eliza would know.
Well, of course she would. But damn it, she's gone.
Did either of you gentlemen frighten her last night?
Of course not. You were there. We hardly said a word to her. Higgins, did you bully her when I went to bed?
Just the other way around. She threw the slippers at me. Without the slightest bit of provocation. The slippers just came and banged at my head before I even uttered a word. That she used the most perfectly awful language. I was shocked.
Well, I'm dashed.
I just don't get it. She was given every possible consideration.
Well, I'm dashed.
Pickering, stop being dashed and do something.
Like what?
Call the police or something. What in the heaven's name are they here for?
Oh, you can't call the police on Eliza as if she were a thief or a lost umbrella.
Why not? I want to find her. She belongs to me. I paid £5 for her.
Hello. Yes, Scotland Yard, please. Thank you. Miss Pierce, would you get me some coffee, please? Yes. Hello, old chap. This is Colonel Hugh Pickering at 27A Wimpole Street. I would like to report a missing person. Anything you can do to speed up her recovery would be frightfully appreciated. I am not a man of small influence and would be happy to speak to your super... Yes, of course. Yes, Eliza Doolittle. I'd say about 26. 5'7", I should say. Color of her eyes.
Brown!
Brown. Color of her hair. I should say it's a neutral sort of nondescript.
Brown! 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 Brown!
No doubt you heard that. Brown. Yes, this is her residence. No relation at all. Well, let's just say she is a good friend. Now, see here, young man, I don't rather like your tone of voice. What she does here is of our concern. Your concern is to find her so she can come back and continue doing it.
What's wrong with her? It's getting closer to the girl. After such a triumph for the poor, what could have possessed her? What could have depressed her? I cannot understand the wretch at all.
You know, Higgins, I have an old school chum at the Home Office. I'll give him a call. Yes. Rigby 74225, please.
Women are irrational. That's all there is to that. The heads are full of cotton hay and rags. They're nothing but exasperating, irritating, vacillating, calculating, agitating, maddening, infuriating hags.
Yes, bust of budgets, please. Go ahead, I will call.
Why can't a woman be more like a man? Why can't a woman be more like a man? A minister honest, so thoroughly square, eternally noble, historically fair. But when you win, we'll always give you back a pat. Why can't a woman be like that? Why does everyone do what the others do? Can't a woman learn to use her head? Why do they do what their mothers do? Why don't they grow up like their fathers instead? Why can't a woman be more like a man? A man is so pleasant, so easy to please. Whenever you're with them, you're always at ease. Would you be slighted if I didn't talk for hours?
Of course not.
Would you be livid if I had a drink or two?
Never.
Would you be wounded if I never sent you flowers?
Nonsense.
Why can't a woman be like you?
Oh, yes. Buster Budgeons, please. Oh, Boozie, it's so good to hear your voice. You will never guess who this is. Yes, that's precisely who it is. My, what a memory you have. How long has it been? 30 years. My, that's a lot of water under the thing. Well, let me tell you why I'm calling, Boozy. You see, something rather unfortunate's happened on this end, and I was hoping I could come by and see you. Perhaps you could help me out with it. Oh, great. I'll be right over. Good to talk to you, Boozy. Well, Miss Pierce, I'll be going to the Home Office.
Oh, I do hope you find her, Colonel Pickering. Mr. Higgins is going to miss her so.
Mr. Higgins is going to miss her so. Blast Mr. Higgins, I am going to miss her.
Hickory!
Oh, he's gone to the Home Office, sir.
You see that, Mrs. Pierce? I'm disturbed and he runs for help. Now that's a good fellow. Mrs. Pierce, you're a woman. Why can't a woman be more like a man? If I was a woman, who'd been to a ball, been held as a princess by one and by all, would I start weeping like a bathtub overflowing? Or carry on as if my head were in a tree? Would I leave and never tell me where I'm going? Why can't a woman be like me?